No, you can't. So they're, because they're not the same thing, they're not like terms. X's and x squareds are very different. They're different, literally different dimensions. Alright, so no, we can't put those together. So I can only put an x squared together with what? Another x squared, and here's some x squareds here. How many x squareds do we have all together?
Four.
There we go. Two x squareds total of 4x squared. Okay, now that you see that.
So if you were to times it, would it be like 4x, like fourth, instead of 2x's, that'd be 4x's?
If we were. Can you bring that up towards the end?
Yeah.
Because that's a point I also want to make.
Oh, no.
We don't want to confuse it, adding them and multiplying them.
Okay.
Short answer is yes, you're right. It would be 4x to the fourth. Okay, 4x minus 5x, those are both x terms. They're like terms, we can put those together. So what do we have? 4x minus 5x is negative 1x. And we have just numbers, right? Just ones. There's 3 ones and negative 8 ones. Put those together, 3 minus 8, negative 5. We did it. Okay? We added 2 polynomials. Okay? We're going to get into what a polynomial means exactly, but that definitely is a polynomial. That's another polynomial. We just add them together. Nothing scary. All right, now you try one. Again, on your own. Won't interfere. Just check until I'm here. Okay, no worries. All right, do it just fine. So we got 5x squared plus 4x squared is how many x squared? 9x squared. 3x minus 9x. 3x plus negative 9x, yes, is negative 6x. Negative 2 plus 7 is a positive 5. Okay. All right, so now let's see if we can subtract the green one from the black one. Now keep in mind, I'm saying to subtract the green polynomial, like the whole polynomial, subtract the whole thing from that thing. Okay. Let's see how you interpret that. Now I'm going to subtract the green polynomial. If I just write this, and I'm not subtracting the green polynomial, I'm subtracting just this part. If I want to subtract all of it, I need some kind of way to group the whole thing together and show you that I'm subtracting the whole thing.
Parentheses.
There we go. So with this negative telling me to subtract everything in the parentheses, how can I do that? Like, how can I deal with this minus in front of the parentheses?
Do everything in the parentheses first.
Well, okay, but there's not really anything to do. There's no like terms to combine. What's that?
Do 3 times 2x2.
No, because this isn't multiplied. Oh. It doesn't say 3 times. This is 3 minus.
3 minus. You times it by 1. Negative 1 times 2.
Yeah, this is a negative 1. So negative 1 times, what's this called? Yeah, so we're distributing a negative 1. So all the parts of the green thing need to be made negative, need to have a negative multiplied by them. Okay. We have 2x squared plus 4x plus 3 minus 2x squared plus 5x plus 8. 2x squared, what's 2x squared minus 2x squared?
0.
0, right? 0x squared, just 0. Now I see a lot of times 2x squared minus 2x squared is x squared. Like you just cancel out the 2's. So 2x squared minus 2x squared, just like if this represented an x squared, and this represented an x squared, this would be 2x squared, right? And if I subtract 2x squared, there's just nothing. There's not x squared, there's nothing at all. Just 0. So that's just blank. It's gone. 4x plus 5x, 9x, 3 plus 8 is
1.
What? Okay. So we're learning to add and subtract polynomials. Add polynomials together? Well, that's pretty simple. That's just combining like terms. Subtract would mean, well, I need to make everything negative first, and then I just add it together. Here, like, goes away or it goes in the jail. now, please, have calculators you can use. Everybody, and it goes over there. Okay, so 9x plus 11. Good. You try it again. Subtract the green from the black. See if you can do it yourself. No help. Solo. Okay, so I'm going to subtract this polynomial, which is the green polynomial. What I'm going to do first with that parentheses around it, with the negative outside.
One. Distribute.
Distribute that negative 1 that we all know is there. This turns into 5x squared plus 3x plus 2 minus 4x squared.
Plus 9x.
Plus
10 minus 7.
Minus 7. 5x squared minus 4x squared.
1x squared.
1x squared. 3x. Plus 9x.
12x.
And the negative 2 minus 7.
Minus 9.
Minus 9. Alright. So, nice little warm up. Your basic stuff. Alright, now I have a little bit of vocab to get into. Alright,
wow.
So then, what's that?
Oh.
Well, vocab's important because when I later say, you know, what's the degree of this polynomial, or look at the degree of four polynomial, or, you know, talk about the leading coefficient, or monomials and binomials, we just need words so that I can refer to things without having to go up and point at the specific thing. Just say, look at the degree, look at the leading coefficient, we can talk about it. So, they're really simple things. But the first vocab part, we can talk about the word polynomial. Right, so take a look at those six example words, all with the prefix poly.
Which means five.
Poly means five?
It means many.
It means
oh.
Many.
Oh.
Polygon, what's a many gone?
What thing?
What thing is it? What's a polygon?
I don't remember.
What's that? It's a shape with many
sides.
Many sides. Poly, many, theism. What's polytheism?
I have no idea.
Many theism. Many theses.
You guys have taken a history class before, haven't you?
No.
Polytheism.
No. Oh, I know.
What is
isn't
it?
Isn't it like, I'm pretty sure it's like way more than.
That's polytheistic.
It's poly.
Yeah. Polytheism, polytheistic, right? It's all the same base, polytheism. Many, I believe, many gods. Polyhedron, you might not know, but you know it's many somethings. Okay.
Many hedrons.
Okay. So a polyhedron is a many-sided figure, but this is three dimensions. This is a polygon, it's a two-dimensional figure. A polyhedron would be a three-dimensional figure with many sides, like a cube.
Tetrahedron.
Your cube.
Tetrahedron. You know what a tetrahedron is? What's it look like?
It's a gigantic triangle. Many sides.
It's a gigantic triangle.
It's like a pyramid.
Yes. It's a pyramid where the all sides are triangles.
You mean the Illuminati?
I don't know what you're not.
It's the Illuminati.
So like the pyramids in Egypt, the great pyramids, they have a square base. The tetrahedron has a triangle base. And all the sides. The tetrahedron, dodecahedron, 20-sided figure.
Cubahedron?
Is
that
a thing? No, it's not. But a dodecahedron is a 20-sided figure. All of the shapes are the same. Do you know where a dodecahedron is used?
Games?
Yeah, 20-sided dice. The Dungeons and Dragons is a popular one.
Yeah, they have
20-sided dice.
Yeah.
They do.
What about like a
if you go into a game store and ask to see a 20-sided die, it's all made up, I think.
Mr. Stewart, do you play Dungeons and Dragons?
What's that?
Do you play Dungeons and Dragons?
I don't, but I wish I had.
What?
You should totally play.
I
think it's
up
my alley.
But I'm not sure.
Let's skip over that one real quick. Polysyllabic. What does syllabic?
It means many syllables.
Yes, many syllables. Like the word polysyllabic.
Oh.
As many syllables. Monosyllabic would be one syllable. Yes. No. Mom, dad. One, two.
Hi.
Okay. Polysyllabic though, many syllables. Polyphonic?
Many phonics.
What is phonic?
Phone.
Phonos. Phone.
Phonos.
Phonic, right? Like sounds. tones.
At least that one looked when I was little.
What?
The little one is the second.
Oh, what? The polyphonic?
Yeah.
Oh, I don't know if it's a new one. It might be, but.
I don't know if it is either, but what you just said.
Well, all of you have something that's polyphonic. Your phones are polyphonic. Now, a little history lesson in phones.
History lesson in phones.
We did not always have polyphonic phones. Polyphonic phones are what allow you to have like a Taylor Swift song as your ringtone. Okay. You can play lots of different tones all at once. You can hear the instruments, you can hear her voice, right? But
Like band.
But before, like early cell phones, they were monophonic. They could play one tone at a time, like old school 8-bit video games. One tone at a time.
They were giant.
Huh?
They were pretty big.
Yes. So our ringtones that we would pay for a download, like they would be like Metallica or something, but they would just be one tone, like you were listening to an old video game version of Metallica.
2 frames per second.
They'd be the best.
So it was the polyphony of the newer phones that allowed them to play all those different tones all at the same time.
I see where you're going with
this. Now, polygraph. You know what the other name of a polygraph is?
That's
a little word. Colloquial.
I think it's a
colloquial. Like every day. Like.
That sounds awesome.
Average. They say like a. Okay, well,
it sounds like a galaxy.
Isn't it like a lie detector type thing?
Yes, a lie detector is the colloquial term for polygraph. They call it a lie detector. The guy who invented the polygraph didn't call it a lie detector, said it's a polygraph.
This is a polygraph.
So it has many graphs. It's graphing your pulse, it's graphing sweat, it's graphing
everything.
Lots of different things about your body.
Blood pressure,
temperature.
Some changes.
Right.
I would fail that so hard because like I would just know that I'm plugged in. Like, oh, what if I
just don't make a sudden change? You just kind of don't move at all.
Yeah, but if you're sitting there and you're like, and it starts to like move,
yes.
And you think
I
it's
think
like, oh, you're
fine.
Telling.
Well,
you
that's
like,
the thing. What? So what?
You just gotta be modified.
Okay, here's how it works. If you're like so scared and jittery, and then everything's already like pumped up, and then they ask, and like before the end, like, okay, this is what how he's acting right now, and then if you're a lie. No, because that would change in what you were like before.
Well, it gets your to get a baseline.
Exactly.
So anyway, poly means many.
I know.
All right. So did you hear at the beginning of class? Did you hear the prefix poly?
Yeah.
In what? What word had the
polynomial?
So polynomial. Poly means many. Polynomial means many nomials. What does a nomial sound like?
Numbers.
Oatmeal.
Numbers? Sounds kind of like oatmeal. Okay. So, a polynomial has many. And nomial is probably closely related to the word number. But I'm going to just say terms. There's many terms. Okay, several different terms added, subtracted together makes a polynomial. Quiet, you're going to go in the hallway.
No.
Okay.
Shh.
Answer.
I need you to answer.
I will later.
He's
in the hallway. Polynomial, many terms. Okay, so here's an example of a polynomial. X is an example of a polynomial. But this is actually a polynomial of one term, so it's what we call a
monomial.
That's x squared plus 2.
Polynomial.
It's poly. How many terms are there?
5.
That's what we call a binomial.
5.
Because there's two terms. How about x cubed minus 2x squared plus 2x? Good trinomial. We can go on like this forever. You can say quadnomial, pentanomial. But we tend to stop at trinomial. We only talk about quadnomials of that often. We call it a four-term polynomial. Polynomial with 4 terms. Polynomial with 17 terms. So when you hear the words monomial, binomial, trinomial, they're just a polynomial with that many terms in it. Okay? So it says, when your book starts to talk about like the product of two binomials, it just
means...
Oh,
I see now. Okay, gotcha.
A two-term polynomial times a two-term polynomial. That's all that's talking about. But we're not multiplying binomials or anything like that today. We're adding and we're subtracting polynomials. Okay? So there's poly, a little language lesson that Haley helped with a lot by telling us that poly means many. Couple of little words left here, degree and leading coefficient. The degree, okay, of a polynomial is the highest exponent. The highest exponent is what you would call the degree. So if we look at this guy, what's the highest exponent you see of this polynomial?
Two.
Look again.
This one right here?
Yeah, that's a 3. The highest power you see is 3, so we call it degree 3. What's the highest exponent you see here?
X2.
So it's degree 2. Okay? Do you have to take that away from you as well?
No.
You're grounded.
You're grounded.
And this last guy, what's the highest power you see in this polynomial?
1x.
Very good. The highest power is 1x. So it's a degree 1 polynomial. Let me quiz you real quick on what the degree of this next thing is. Dx plus 5x plus x. What degree is this polynomial?
4.
4.
Right?
4.
It is 4. Make sure you pay attention to the highest exponent, not the first exponent that you see. Highest one is 4, so it's a degree 4. All right, how do you know it's degree 4? What term tells you that it's degree 4?
The exponent of 4.
This one with the exponent of 4, right? So you found this term, -7x^4 is the one that tells you the degree. Once you found the degree, this tells you the degree. The degree. And this guy right here, what do you think that might be?
Where it's located?
It's the...
Oh, leading coefficient.
Coefficient.
Okay. So it has a leading coefficient of -7. That'll be... I wouldn't be able to say leading coefficient to you and produce a Matthew Schrodinger loop. I want you to be able to look at this and say the leading coefficient is -7, the degree is 4. Right? Not that difficult, it's just a word or a term that you have to learn. No, throw it back. Stop doing that. Okay, in the hole.
Bye.
So one last little quiz about...
Wait, why would that be the leading one? Because wouldn't that be 5? Because five is bigger than -7. And
if that were the rule, then you'd be right. But the rule is, it's the...
Just like the biggest number.
Not the biggest number. It's the coefficient with the degree.
Okay, yeah.
So the degree really kind of decides what the leading coefficient is. We call it leading because if we were to write this in the way that we traditionally write polynomials, with the highest power first, and then going down from there, it would look like -7x^4, followed by a +3x^3, +5x² +2x -1. If we were to write them in order of power, then look at what we have, the lead, right? The -7. Right, and that last thing that you brought up before, just be careful. If you see x³ + x², there's still a temptation for you to say that's x^5. But I want you to think about this, because you know what exponents mean, and you don't really need me to tell you this. You could explain this to yourself. I'm just going to use the knowledge you have, and I'm going to draw it out of your minds and show you. What does x^5 mean?
Hmm?
To the fifth power. What does it mean to take a number to the fifth power?
So that means stuff is five. Like
five of them doing what?
Multiplying.
Oh. Yes, okay. Multiplying five x's together is exactly what x to the fifth means. Okay? So if anything is equal to x to the fifth, it must be equal in some way to five x's. You multiply together. Let's look at the left side. What does x to the third mean? Well, what is, just let's look at x to the third and talk about that. What does x to the third mean? What does it mean to take a number to the third power?
Ten to the three.
Well, itself three times. Three x's multiplied together. How about what does x squared mean?
X times
x. Yeah, so we got x times x. Well, here's the three x's being multiplied together, the two x's being multiplied together. And what are we doing with these three x's and these two x's?
Put them together.
In what way? With
plus.
With addition.
So instead of that being three and two will be five. If you're imagining them on the left either.
Yeah. Am I?
Yes. Well, you're pulling. So you're going x times x times x times x, which will be x times five.
Take a close look. Let's use some specific numbers and see.
Yeah, so it's say so. If we were talking about like x was 2, so it would be like 2.
Yeah, x was 2,
two,
so 2 to the third.
2 times 2 would be
square.
4, and then it would go to 2 times 2 again, and then it would keep multiplying.
That's exactly how it works.
Well, let's take a look. This is 2 times 2 times 2, right? 2 to the third is 2 times 2 times 2. 2 squared is 2 times 2.
Then you add those
stop
two
talking to each other. Look up at the board. I'm trying to do something simple, but it's taking a lot longer than necessary. We're adding this 2 to the 3rd plus 2 squared. Is that the same as this 2 to the 5th, which is 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2?
Yeah.
No.
Yes.
This is the same as that?
No. Wait, no, no, no.
So take a look, we've got 3 2's here and 2 2's.
Yeah, that would be 4. 2 times 2 is 4.
4.
And 2 times 2 times 2 is 8.
8, so 8 plus 4
is
12.
Yeah.
What's 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2?
4, 8,
32. Is 12 equal to 32?
No.
No, because look at the difference. We do have 2 2's and 3 2's, just like we do over here, 2 times 2 and 2 times 2 times 2. 2 and 2 times 2 times 2. The difference is they're being added here, and over here they're being what? Multiplied together. Added together?
Multiplied
together. Are addition and multiplication the exact same operation?
No.
So, we cannot say that 2 to the third plus 2 squared is 2 to the fifth. We can't say x to the third plus x squared is x to the fifth. Okay, they don't. But if this were multiplication, x2 cubed times 2 squared, well, then that would be 5x, 5 2's multiplied together. If this were x cubed times x squared, then we'd have x times x times x times x times x, which is 5x's multiplied together, and that would be x to the fifth. But x cubed plus x squared is not equal to x to the fifth. You can't add them together and add their exponents. Multiply them together, you can add their exponents together. But only if you multiply. You're adding